Hello everybody, welcome back to Kingdom of Learning. I hope all of you are doing fine. So today in this video I'm going to talk about the most coveted course of all the students, means most favorite course of all the students, that is English Honors course. First of all, let me tell you what are we going to cover up in this video. First of all, I'll be telling you what is the importance of this course of English Honors. Second thing will be whether there will be an entrance test or not. Then I'll be telling you about what is the syllabus of English Honors, and then at last I will tell you whether I did English Honors or not. So stay tuned and just watch the video till last, and if you find the information to be useful, at last you have to like the video and you have to share it with others. So the first thing is that actually what happens that most of the students, whether they are from humanities stream, whether they are from commerce stream, or whether they are from science stream, so I think definitely they all think that ki kisi bhi course mein nahi hoga to English honors to hai hi, right? So I think that is very much true. Means when we talk to our students, they also have the same attitude कि कहीं नहीं होगा तो इंग्लिश ऑनर्स कर लेंगे, बिकॉज दे थिंक कि इंग्लिश इज द इजिएस्ट सब्जेक्ट. मीन्स इन देयर 12th स्टैंडर्ड, इन देयर 10th स्टैंडर्ड, 11th स्टैंडर्ड, दे गॉट मैक्सिमम मार्क्स इन इंग्लिश, एंड दैट वेरी इजी, दैट टू वेरी इजीली. सो दे हैव दिस अजम्पशन दैट इंग्लिश ऑनर्स इज वेरी इजी, सो दे कीप इट एज अ साइड थिंग. ऑल आई टॉक अबाउट इज परस्यूइंग इंग्लिश ऑनर्स इज सो इजी एज इट इज अज्यूम्ड बाय द स्टूडेंट्स, or it is very difficult. So let me clarify one thing here, that pursuing English honors is not that easy as it is considered by the students. Means if you compare your English of class 11th and 12th with that of the course of English honors, so you will be shocked. Means it's not that much key, though you have two very thin books and you have to just read few chapters and you have to prepare few writing skills and it will be all over. No, English honors is not like that, exactly not at all like that. So first thing you should know that this is not like that. So now the thing is that English honors is actually, earlier there used to be an entrance test for this, for DU, and now this year Delhi University has decided not to give any entrance test. So I think it will make this course more popular than earlier also, because earlier some students would stop at this thing that they would have to appear in the entrance test, and this year they don't have any entrance, so there will be more people who will definitely be opting for this course. Now we will talk about the syllabus of English Honors course. What is the syllabus? So actually I'm not going to tell you exact syllabus here, because this video will become very long. I'm just roughly telling you what is generally covered up in the syllabus of English Honors course. So English Honors does not mean one book or two books. It will have so many books. Means in that English Honors course only you will have to read so many books based on different kinds of literature, different writers you will have to study. Means I can simply tell you that in your 11th and 12th, what were you doing? You were reading simply one short story written by a particular writer. But in English Honors, what you will have to do, you will have to study a complete author. Means writers will be there in your syllabus, not a particular book or chapter written by them. You will have to study Shakespeare. Suppose, for example, Shakespeare is in your course. So what does it mean? That you may be asked any question from the works of Shakespeare. So it's like that. Means you will have to study American literature. You will have to, I'm talking about all the entire course. It may be divided year wise. So you will have to study European literature, you will have to study Indian literature, Indian poetry, Indian novel, Indian drama. Different sections will be there, and that does not mean that only one writer or one chapter or one book, it will mean all, everything related to that particular era or that particular writer. You will have to study the whole history of English literature also. So means it starts from the time of Chaucer and till this contemporary era. You will have to study that. So if you are mentally prepared, if you have that means interest in reading that much literature, I'm not demotivating anybody. So means English honors is not a cakewalk. Means just I want to tell you that English honors is not a cakewalk that anybody can easily have it and eat it also. So English honors means a lot of study. So if you are ready for that much study, actually, you know, it is not difficult for those people who have this habit of reading, who enjoy reading. So if you are that kind of a person that you enjoy reading different books, you enjoy this literature, you enjoy this poetry, you are into all those things, you are creative minded, then definitely this course is for you. You should not leave it. You should go ahead with this, right? So another thing is that now I can tell you, means if you are very technical minded, if you think that you are not a reader, you don't enjoy reading such literature and fictitious works, then I think you should opt for something else. That will be, I'm telling you, a very practical thing. I'm not going I'm not going to demotivate anybody, but I'm telling you the facts. So don't take it in that. Now I will tell you about the career options after pursuing this course of English honors. Means suppose after listening this much, I think you must have made up your mind that whether you want to pursue this course or not. So if you have decided that yes, I have to do this thing only, then definitely there are very good career options after doing English honors. So first thing is that you can become a teacher of English, you can become a lecturer, a teacher in school, a teacher in college, anywhere you can easily become. After that you will have to pursue some certain other courses like B.Ed or M.Phil, Ph.D. etc. So you can do that. You will have to do masters also. Then you can go for journalism and mass media also, because there also language people are required. Then you can go for creative writing, you can go for content writing, you can go for digital marketing companies also, because they need content writers, and go there also. You can write good content and you will be paid. You can become a writer also, after all, at last. Means if you are interested in reading books, definitely one day you will like to write a book also. So consider all these things before taking the step ahead to pursue this English honors thing. So now I want to tell you whether I did English honors or not. So here my answer is no. I did not pursue English honors because in our times, English honors was not much in trend, you can say. We used to do like BA. After that, I did my MA in English, post graduation in English. Means English was a subject in BA also. And then in MA detailed, means whatever I have told you about English honors, same things we did in our MA English. So those were the days which I enjoyed and I miss the most in my life when I was doing this MA in English, because I had that interest in that thing. Means the college, going to the college, spending time in the library, listening to the lectures of our teachers, and then reading for the whole nights. I enjoyed those things because I was interested in all those things. So I never found it to be a burden. Rather, I liked it. I enjoyed it. Means we used to read such thick books, novels. We enjoyed them. And we were always there in the library to search for more and more books which we could read. Cutoffs of English honors are also very high. Let me tell you, I will place the entire list of the cutoffs of last year of different colleges of DU here. So you can check that. So I think it's time to say bye. So do subscribe to the channel if you are new to it, and do share this video with others. Thank you.